Penguin Audio presents You Can Date Boys When You're 40, written and read by Dave Barron. This is not really a book about parenting. I say this because the title clearly refers to parenting, which may have given you the impression that the actual book is about parenting. But there's a wise old saying that goes, you can't judge a book by its cover. Like so many wise old sayings, this is stupid, because of course most of the time you can judge a book by its cover. The whole point of the cover is to tell you what the book is about. For example, if the cover says, Cooking on a Budget, you know the book contains inexpensive recipes. And if the cover says, Lose Weight Fast, you know the book contains lies. But as they say, this book isn't really about parenting. It mentions parenting, but also covers many other topics, including grammar, sex, camels, women, brain surgery, sex with women, how to become a professional author, airlines, Justin Bieber, and death. That's why my original idea was to give the book a more vague and general title. Here are some of the titles I submitted to the publisher. Dave Barry's Vague General Book of Humor Topics. Dave Barry's Guide to Whatever This Book is About. Dave Barry, a Dave Barry book by Dave Barry. Dave Barry, you probably thought he was dead. But the marketing people wanted something more specific, and they liked the idea of a title that was about family and or parenting. So after rejecting several more of my suggestions, including Without Family, We Would Have Nothing, Except Way More Money and Spare Time, they went with the current title, You Can Date Boys When You're 40. Those words do appear in one of the essays in this book, and they are words that I have actually said to my daughter, Sophie. As I write this, Sophie is 13 years old, which, as you veteran parents of daughters know, is a terrifying age because of puberty. Girls do not go through puberty the way boys do. For boys, puberty is a gradual process. It took me decades, and it's not all that drastic. When the boy is done undergoing puberty, he's hairier and smellier, but still basically the same. Female puberty is a whole different kettle of biological fish. For years, my daughter was this sweet, innocent little girl who played with dolls, slept with stuffed animals, and viewed me as a wise authority figure because of all the amazing things I knew how to do, such as tell time. Then one day, at about 4:30 in the afternoon, Sophie went into her bathroom, which is pink, and whoom! Some kind of massive hormone bomb went off in there. She emerged maybe 45 minutes later, having aged, biologically, at least 7 years. Suddenly, she was this woman, with legs and everything, walking around. The same thing happened pretty much simultaneously to all her friends. All of them were suddenly beautiful, feminine, poised, sophisticated, and several linear feet taller than the boys their age. The day the hormone bomb detonated marked the end of the era wherein my daughter viewed me as an authority. These days, pretty much the only time she turns to me for guidance is when she can't find the Cinnamon Toast Crunch. When she needs to discuss anything more important, school, relationships, hair, clothes, makeup, hair accessories, and biological matters I don't even want to think about, she confers with her several hundred closest girlfriends or my wife, who is also a woman. I am way out of the loop. I don't even know where the loop is. Nevertheless, I am legally Sophie's father, and I have certain fundamental obligations, the main one being to protect her from harm, with harm defined as men. As a lifelong male myself, I am well aware of the way we think, and I don't want anybody thinking things like that within a 1,000-yard radius of my daughter. The problem I am facing right now is boys, which biologically are nothing more than short men. My daughter's school is infested with them. Lately, they have taken to hanging around our house, darting around out there on bicycles and skateboards, and trying to act as though they are not thinking about what they are thinking about, which we all know is exactly what they are thinking about. Here's what really bothers me. Sometimes they get inside the house. I blame my wife. If it were up to me, our house would be surrounded by giant but humane traps baited with some kind of bait that would be attractive to 13-year-old boys, such as fireworks, or shorts that are even baggier than the shorts they're already wearing. Every now and then we'd hear the loud thwonk of a steel door slamming shut, indicating that a 13-year-old boy had come too close to the house. I would then go outside and, after a stern warning, drive the boy out to the Everglades and release him into the wild. But my wife allows them to come in. She has never been a 13-year-old boy, so she thinks it's okay if sometimes one of them watches TV with Sophie, the two of them eating popcorn and sitting in the family room on the exact same sofa. If it were up to me, I would insist that the boy had to sit on an entirely separate piece of furniture, which would be located in Iceland. But because of my wife's naive soft-heartedness, we have this potentially catastrophic situation that requires me to casually stroll past the family room every 8 to 10 seconds, back and forth and back and forth, a dad on patrol, each time casually glancing inside to make sure nothing is happening. I'm thinking of getting some kind of firearm, which every now and then I would casually discharge into the family room ceiling. Ha ha! That will give Mr. Shortman something to think about. Only 27 more years to go. But I have drifted away from my point, which is that this is not really a book about parenting. It's about many things, which you will find out if I ever stop introducing it so you can go ahead and listen to it. I hope you enjoy it, and I hope that amid the laughs, you find some actual nuggets of wisdom. If you do, let me know what they are, okay? I'll be hovering right outside the family room. Sophie, Stella, and the Bieber Plan. In the movie Taken, Liam Neeson plays a father whose daughter is kidnapped by evil pervert sex traffickers with foreign accents. Fortunately, Liam's character is a former spy, and he uses his espionage skills to go on a desperate quest, during which he terminates an estimated 125 bad guys with his bare hands before he finally tracks down his daughter and saves her. Taken is on cable a lot, and every time I stumble across it, I watch the whole thing, because it combines two artistic themes with classic enduring appeal. Liam Neeson beating the crap out of foreign perverts, and fatherhood. If you're a man with a daughter, you can't watch this movie without imagining yourself in Liam's position, wondering how far you would go for the sake of your daughter, what desperate life-threatening measures you would be willing to take. Well, I don't have to wonder anymore. I took my daughter to a Justin Bieber concert. How bad was it, you ask? It was so bad that I cannot hear you asking me how bad it was. My hearing has been destroyed by 17,000 puberty-crazed girls shrieking at the decibel level of global thermonuclear war. It turns out that the noise teenage girls make to express rapturous happiness is the same noise they would make if their feet were being gnawed off by badgers. Also, for some reason, being happy makes them cry. The girl next to me spent the entire concert bawling and screaming, quote, "I love you!" directly into my right ear. She was not screaming at me, of course. She was screaming to cute boy Canadian heartthrob Justin Bieber, as were all the other girls, including my daughter Sophie and her BFF, Stella Sable. BFF stands for Best Friends Forever. This is a term that girls my daughter's age use to describe essentially everyone they know. Sophie and Stella wore matching purple tutus. Purple, as you are no doubt aware, is Justin's favorite color, and spent the entire concert bouncing up and down, shrieking and vibrating like tuning forks. They are big fans. Sophie has covered one corner of her room, she calls it the corner of appreciation, with pictures of Justin Bieber gazing at the camera with the soulful expression of a person who truly believes, deep in his heart, that he is the best-looking human ever. On March 1st, which, as you are no doubt aware, is Justin Bieber's birthday, Sophie posted on Instagram that he is, quote, the perfectest person on the planet. One day, while I was looking at the corner of appreciation, Sophie and I had the following exchange. Me. You know, Justin Bieber doesn't have any idea who you are. Sophie. Not yet. This exchange disturbed me. I don't want my daughter's life goal to be to meet, and I say this respectfully, an overhyped twerp. Don't get me wrong, I'm not one of those fathers who think that no man will ever be good enough for their daughters. I'm sure there's somebody out there who is worthy of Sophie, and I sincerely hope that she meets him someday, with someday defined as after I have been dead for a minimum of 3 months and all efforts to revive me have failed. Even then, if Sophie's going to go on dates with this male, I want to go along. My body can ride in the back seat with an air freshener. Speaking of death, my wife nearly experienced it before the concert started. I have seen my wife perform some amazing physical feats. I once saw her produce from somewhere inside her body a live human being. But nothing I've seen her do was as brave, if not foolhardy, as what she did when we got to the Justin Bieber concert. Namely, she purchased officially licensed Justin Bieber merchandise for Sophie and Stella. To do this, she had to battle her way through what was basically a mom riot. Several hundred frenzied women engaged in a desperate elbow-throwing struggle against other moms to reach the merchandise counter so they could pay upwards of $50 apiece for Justin Bieber t-shirts for their daughters. God forbid this should happen, but if we ever go to war with Japan again, and they embed their forces deep inside heavily fortified caves on Iwo Jima again, instead of sending in the Marines, all we need to do is put the word around that the Japanese forces are in possession of overpriced Justin Bieber merchandise. Within minutes, they will be overrun by moms fully capable of decapitating an opposing...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.